Hello, ladies and gentlemen, yet another time! I'm back for episode 7, and apparently a bunch of stuff has happened, as you can see. So, let me fill you in with the details. As you can see, I added 2 more lasers, just so this assembly table works a bit faster. B, I've rerouted all my power down here. We now have the energy cell supplying power to every single setup we have in this area. So like these two are currently not in use. This is getting power from these 3 generators. It's routed somewhere around here to here. It's getting from there. And then it outputs power to the rock crusher. It outputs power to our machines upstairs. And it outputs power to this CESU, which converts it into EU and then into the electric heat generator, which then makes a bunch of steel. So between episodes, while I was rerouting in power and stuff, I was producing a stack of steel. And how did I do that? I built in a whole lot of crafting steps, I built these 9 hardened solar panels. So each of these outputs 8 RF per tick. So if you look into this solar panel, these are the ones, and they generate 8 RF per tick, so for a total of 9 times 8 is 72 RF per tick. Yes, this is our main power gen for the moment. It's enough to keep this running. It's basically enough for everything I'm currently using, and if I need more power, I can always use these 3 generators. So this was the power... creeper in our setup. This is not good. Come here, creeper, let me kill you. So this was the thing I was promising you between episodes. Many of you might have guessed it by what is this, whatever, many of you might have guessed it by looking at my NEI, where I was talking about the power gen in the end segment. That was kind of spoiler, I guess. But for those of you who didn't notice, this was the power gen setup I was talking about. So just solar panels. They're rather easy to craft. You need a ton of steel, obviously, but that's not too big of a problem. We have not enough iron, and with enough AFKing, that's easily done. And then you just need electronite for these photovoltaic cells, and some lead and some iron and some redstone. That's basically it. So and some glass. Yeah, that's rather easy. And then you just combine them with the hardened solar core, 8 of them, with the standard core and some invar nuggets, and you're there. So this is rather easy and yeah, straightforward. The second thing I was doing was outline a bit of a base wall thing. So I've been having problems with monsters here and there, and there were a bunch of creeper holes all over the place. So I figured, why not wall off the area, and so I can light everything in the area, and everything outside I don't care about, because this will simply be closed off, and everything that spawns outside I don't care about. The third thing, I've been doing some crop mutations. I've been getting some beans and some rice, and currently I'm trying to get some soybeans to make myself a culinaric generator, just because I figured that would be a good way to power a tree farm. Since I want to automate the food production as well, and if I have some soybeans, I can make some tofu, and so food production will be a bit better, and the culinary generators I really like as a whole, and yeah, that's basically it. So I will probably do a very big farm with 1 or 2 harvesters, harvesting everything I want, so harvesting these, harvesting wood, and harvesting food. And harvesting like sugarcane and stuff. So one big farm with 1 or 2 harvesters should do the trick. And yeah, for the outline of the base, I obviously made some of this smooth stone and made them into bricks. Enough, 4 of them. Nice. So I just wanted to 2 stairs to finish this thing up. Let's put this in here. I don't know what. Let's do it like following. That looks okay, I guess. So I just wanted to mark this node so I don't create anything that would break the node. Okay, so this episode, I want to tear into the first few machines. And to do that, I obviously need the magma crucible, this one, and I need the fluid transposer. Because I want to get to plastic. That was the problem I encountered. And to get to plastic, we need rocket fuel A and we need compressed sawdust. And for the compressed sawdust, I can either use the witch's oven or just get a sawmill, which I probably will go for right away. So the sawmill should be craftable for me. Yes, it is. So an iron axe, some copper gears, redstone, reception coil, and a machine frame. Machine frames, I have three at the moment, I think. Yes, one in there and two I have in my machines chest here. So that shouldn't be a problem. Let me real quick clean out my inventory. Oh yeah, and the apple, that one was one thing I wanted to show you. I didn't want to do it off camera, for those of you who don't know. Combining an apple with a cobblestone piece gets you a devnull. And to show you what a devnull does, just avoid some cobblestone. You right click it into empty space, like the air, and you put in cobblestone. Let's get like this, yeah. For example, if you have 32 in there and you drop a piece of cobblestone or three pieces or two pieces, whatever, it will pick them up and they should go into, let's do it like this, one over here and one over there. So if I pick these up, they go into my devnull, like this. And if I pick these up, they won't go anywhere because they go into the devnull, and if the devnull is full, it voids the things. So basically, it's always having, I can place blocks with it, and if I break them and pick them up, they go into the devnull again. So basically, if you're mining, you can just put this to like cobblestone and you mine downstairs strip mining, and you won't get your inventory clogged up with cobblestone and have them to, you have to put them into a lava lake every now and then. So yeah, that's a really neat thing. I will put this into my mining slash things chest here. Let's put them like this. Let me grab a piece of bronze very quick and repair my shovel. And then we will continue with our quest for the sawmill. So clean out inventory. Yes, and some glass. Nice. Very good. So yeah, as you can see, I have some refined iron, like a neat little supply. All right, so next up, sawmill. So we need a iron axe, as already talked about. Let's get three iron and some sticks. Here's my wood, here it is. So two sticks and three iron make an iron axe used for crafting only. Yes, it does. Wood planks, nothing easier than that. Then we need reception coil and two copper gears. Hopefully we have some left. No, we don't. Okay, the reception coil is rather easy, and the copper gear shouldn't be too hard as well. So we need four pieces of ore, so the double make eight, and then we can cast them out four a piece into a gear cast. I should probably get a second basin, no, the drain, because I have to switch it up every now and then, but whatever. I don't care about this. Grab a gear cast. Wait for this to smelt, and yeah, that's basically it. Let me craft the reception coil real quick. Reception coil, here we go. This there, and like this. Okay. And by the way, I will set them up down there, I guess. This will be my machines room or upstairs. I'm not sure I will figure something out. Probably down here, because this sawmill isn't that much of a mach a manual machine as it is a automated machine down the line. What was I? Yeah, I was waiting for the copper. Here we go. One gear and the second gear, and then we should be good. So yeah, as I said, the copper gears, rather the sawmill is a machine I'm not in, I don't intend to use that much in a manual way, and more in a automated way. So the automated machines I want to set up downstairs. All right, let me sleep real quick, and then let's grab some energy conduits. Yes. So I was using the leadstone ones, leadstone conduits, flux ducts, because yeah, they're rather cheap. Lead plates. Let's make one more. I don't have to use the immersive engineering ones all the time. Metal former rolling. Grab some sulfur. The sulfur I needed for the CESU downstairs, so I can make some batteries. And as you get 16 a piece, I think, out of the ore. No, 24, even more. Let's put the sawmill down. And here. Yeah, why not? We have some conduits running here, and then we can go about it this way. Nice. Okay, then. Let me get my second plate and make some conduits. And the chips. Thank you. There's. I don't have to rake bean seeds, okay. Okay, then. This is up and running. It's getting power, I would guess. It is. Yes, it is. Nice. Very good, nice. One, two, three, four, and we've closed it up. And it's getting power. Nice. Very good. So now we can throw in our wood, which I will do now. Oh, sorry about that. The dishwasher is beeping in the background. All right. So let me wait for some sawdust, and then I have to turn down the dishwasher on. Put it on standby, and I will come back once there's some sawdust. And yes, you can hear it. It wants me to tend to it. So, see you guys in a second, and then we will continue with some more machine producing. Bye bye.
No.
All right, and these are my first few pieces of compressed sawdust. So I made some planks with the sawmill, and as I said, now we will continue with more stuff involving a machine we want. So the magma crucible is the next machine we want to tear into. Some nether bricks, some invar gears, okay, and the leadstone energy shell frame. So there's a reception coil I will can probably craft two times, because I know I will need one for the wood transposer as well. Here we go. And then we need the invar gears. Invar, do we have some invar? We don't. But I know I have some ferrous somewhere. Yes, we do. One ferrous, two ferrous, and four iron. That's the last of our iron. I mean, we have enough, obviously. Then we have 10 blocks of iron. But yeah. Me grab this real quick and plant it again. I should probably keep this in my inventory. Get out here. Okay. So that's these lead plates. Yeah. Let's make some more chipsets. Two more chipsets so we can make some more leadstone flux ducts. Redstone chipset, please. And this should go rather fast compared to the old. Yeah, it's going pretty much faster. Okay, so nether bricks. I think I have some more left. No, I don't. Okay, so four of these smelted. Thank you very much. And we need invargues. We are already smelting the leadstone thing. We need some glass, don't we? Yes, we have four glass in here and some lead. So let me make this. And the bricks and invar here. Okay, so invar 12 and one gear too much. And fluid transposer, we can craft transposer. Copper gears again, some glass, and yeah, a bucket. Okay, so one, two, and we need some more copper. Four again. Let's get out the rest of the ingots. Okay, so glass, we should have enough. Oops. One click too much. Glass, we have enough. Yes, we do. Two and one for the leadstone. Flux ducts, then. Sorry about that. Seems to me everyone's trying to mess up my recording. So, somebody wanted money from me, basically. That's all there is to it. And okay, now we continue with our quest to auto machines. So, where was I? I had made some invar gears. I made some copper gears, hopefully. Yes. And I made some, come on, some bricks in here. Pretty good. So this I should be able to make. Yes, I do. Let's make a bucket. And then we need the magma crucible, which we also should be able to make. Yes, nice. And then our chipset should be ready for us to make some more conduits so we can power this bay. Some redstone, glass, and that should do it. Redstone, lead. There we go. And we have eight of them. Go downstairs. And put the magma crucible and the fluid transposer. Oh yeah, and by the way, disable all the outputs for the time being. So just the machines don't mess something up. And power. Nice. They're getting power. This is getting power. This is not even draining. Very good. Fruit salad. All right, so next up, we want the following. We want a vat. The vat. This one. And to do this, we need a bunch of stuff. Especially, we need the alloy smelter from Ender.io. And this requires us to make a basic capacitor, which is easy enough, except for. Oh, I. Yeah, I do have, I think I have enough of lapis. The electric furnace is easy enough. The induction furnace is rather easy, I think. Yes, it is. Machine casing, lumium. Yes, we need lumium blend, which is like liquid glowstone and some silver and tin. And then we need crushed obsidian, so two electric furnace inductions. Okay, so with these two machines, I will be able to smelt glowstone and fill them into buckets, and with the buckets I can then craft the lumium alloy. So for example, lumium, if you look at the recipe, lumium blend energized glowstone with some tin and silver. And the same with signalum. Signalum blend, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Come on. Signal blend? There it is. So these DLS redstone, some silver and some copper. So let me catch to crafting. This will take quite a while, and I will fill in with the crafting steps as I go. I don't think having me look at machines processing copper into copper plates is funny. So yeah, I will do this, and I will come back once I figure this is worth watching it in. So the first few crafting steps I've already done. Basic machine casing and some carbon plates and some steel plates and some advanced alloy, advanced machine casing. And that combined with an electric furnace and a few pieces of copper, I believe, should make an induction smelter. So now all we need is the capacitor. Capacitor, basic capacitor. So we need signalum, which is copper, silver. So three copper and one silver. And we need to use the dust. So signalum blend, this one. Pulverized silver, silver dust. Macerator, silver ingot. Okay, so we can use the ingots to get to where we want. So we need some more copper. 1, 2, 3. And one silver ingot. We have it. Okay. Here we go. And throw them into the macerator. And by the way, I'm making some more chipsets. Macerator. Too much coal dust. And now we need redstone. And I believe to get one bucket, you need 10 pieces of redstone. So 10 pieces. All right. In a magma crucible, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, and 10. And now we specify the output to the left and the input to the right, so we get this, and then we can get it out via the fluting process. We have stabilized redstone. So how do we... Yes, normal smelting. Thanks a lot. And... we should have silver dust now, and now we only have to wait for the copper. Very good. The second thing is lumium, I think, and this requires glowstone. And glowstone, I believe, was 4 pieces for one bucket, I think. Let's prepare this. Yes, it's the correct number. Nice. 2 pieces of copper dust. Come on now. What else do we need for the capacitor? Sitter. Basic one. 2 redstone chipsets. Yeah, we can manage that, I think. Damn it. Redstone chipsets and the lapis thing. So let's throw in here 2 pieces and make some redstone chipsets, and then we will use this guy and specify another recipe. This Now we should have enough. Yes, we do. As you can see, so many crafting steps to do. Kind of feels like IC2 all over the place. So this and that and some debris stabilized redstone signal blend. Yay! Throw this in here. And we should get signal. Now we need some wire. We don't have some. That's a bummer. Do we have? Yes, we do have electrum. Nice. And some treated sticks. Get wire. Because we need to connect up the. Oh, we need some glass. Well. Grab some sand. And make some glass. We need the. In here, we need some sand to get smelted, and we need to connect in order to. So once the power reaches there, we will have some liquid glass, and then we can pull out our lapis electron tube. All right, so we have an empty bucket. We can now get out our energized glowstone, and then we need. I think it's 3:1 silver to tin for the aluminum. Let me check that once we're out of bed. So aluminum. Aluminum blend. Silver. Tin, tin, tin. Okay. 3 tin. 1 silver and 3 tin. All right. Throw those into the macerator again. The redstone sets should be ready. Yes, they are. Very good. Now we are waiting for this. Put it out. It doesn't have top power, so I will let it connect. Leave it connected up, just in case we need it. Okay. Anything else needed? Alloy smelter. Bar. Oh, we need more capacitors. Oh God. My brain hurts. So we need capacitors. How are they crafted? Yes, with chipsets, of course. More chipsets to craft. Basic capacitor, nice. So we need some more redstone. Let's make 18 chipsets, just so we're on the safe side. Whenever you can, I recommend making extras of anything, just because there seems to be a very high redundancy in some things. So basically, you need steel for basically everything. You need these chipsets for basically everything, so make extras, so in which case you will be thankful in the future. So silver and energized glowstone lumium blend. Let's smelt it in again. And then we need to wait for the bars I already have. Yes, there are some four piece. Let me get my chipsets. One. Let's throw this in here. And a machine frame, of course. I already made this. Two aluminum ingots and some basic capacitors. Come on, come on. Oh, what the hell? Wasn't planned. So, okay. I'll take that as a no. So, wait. Come on, capacitor, please. And of course, this alloy smelter will be useful for other things in the future as well. So, it's not a one wonder machine, one time wonder machine. So chromium ingots, woo. Machine casing. And now we only need this last capacitor, which comes with the two chipsets. Is this running low on power? It is. This is running low on power. It is. So in this case, let's produce some more power manually. Oops. Here we go. This should keep up demands. Yes, it does. Nice. So it's on blue power again. And I should probably disconnect this again. I feel low on power. Okay. Connect it up again. And set ones and twos. Okay. So, by the way, is Lumium a good tool thing? Lumium. 4.5 hearts? Really? Isn't it like Manulin? Blade is 2 hearts, yes. Okay. So, and durability? Wise. It's. Oh my god, is this awesome! And Signalum, I think, is even better. So, like, Signalum, Sword, Blade, 5.5 hearts attack. Okay, so this is like basically outdated, I guess, now that we have access to these awesome alloys. I will probably make one. So, Electron Tube, Signalum Nuggets. It's a capacitor, and we should be able to make an alloy smelter. Yes, we are. Nice. Oh my god, I'm excited. So let's head downstairs again. Down our alloy smelter. Is this getting power? Awesome. Okay, so I will again take a break and sort my inventory and stuff, and I will continue making electrical steel, iron, silicon, and pulverized coal. I believe I need 4 for the vat. For that, let's have a look at this real quick before I end the segment. A furnace, fluid tanks, easy enough. I need a machine casing again. Oh my god, this is so bothersome. Aluminium and more electron tubes, more chipsets, more signal nuggets. All right, we're in for a world of pain. But we only need, we need only 4 of these electrical steel things. So the 4 coal dust we already have. Now we need the silicon. How do we get one? Silicon. Pulverizer, sag mill, pulverizer, sag mill. Okay, so basically it makes us build a pulverizer. Pulverizer. Flint, piston, and a machine frame again. Come on. Okay. Yeah. I will make a pulverizer. I will get some silicon. I will get some electrical steel. And then I will be back. No. Let me get the last piece of iron I need. And then I should be able to craft this baby. So I have the fluid tanks. I have the machine casing. Yes. I think I'm done. I'm done. Grab the last few pieces of snap. We don't need sulfur, we need some iron plates to craft this guy. 4 pieces, 2, and this, and where is my furnace? There. The vat! Nice! Okay. And with the vat, I think we're there. But this guy needs water. And to create the rocket fuel. Rocket fuel. What is this? Bad recipe. Okay, the bad recipe seems to be somewhat funny. And hooch is rather easy. You need some sugar and you need any type of wheat, water, seeds. Poisonous potatoes, especially, are really good. So, between episodes, I think I will craft one of these the liquid tanks, one more to get in and out the fluids. So, what? Oh, you know what? Let's craft one right here, right now. So we should have a piece of glass in here. We do four and four, and the glass in the middle makes a fluid tank. And with this and a bucket of water and some potatoes. Grab a poisonous potato and some sugar. Let's grab a bucket of water. Fill this in. Put it to push on the top. Yes. And then we throw in a poisonous potato and a piece of sugar, and we should get some hooch on the top. And for rocket fuel, we need gunpowder and redstone. Okay. So let me real quick piece of redstone and one piece of gunpowder. And then I think we can craft some plastic this episode, even. There we go. Let's hooch it up. Gunpowder, redstone. Let's put it to push-pull mode. Now we have a second bucket in there. So let me piece of gunpowder and redstone. I should do something about this running back and forth. This is one reason I'm doing the wall round, so I can basically have a. Yes, we're getting rocket fuel in here. Pull it out, bucket of rocket fuel. And now, let's just to be safe, disable this thing. Now with this bucket of rocket fuel, we have the compressed sawdust already. Raw plastic, compressed sawdust. We should be able to make this. And two plastic sheets, nice. Harvester. Binvarak, I believe we already had all of this. Oh yeah, we need the machine casing. All right. So between episodes, this is obviously the end of the episode. It's rather long, so I will end it here. Between episodes, I will make another machine frame and prepare everything we need to have for crafting our first harvester. And from there on, I think we will progress really nicely. There's very much tech ahead of our way. I believe with the harvester and other machines that require plastic, the way we can tear through and get power gen up to a point where we can maybe use a second assembly table or something, or even get some more processing done. I think with this, the progress we can make is getting faster and faster, and also we can now with more machines, we can now build some pipes, build some other things that help automate some things. For example, the iron production, steel production. Like I already said, we can harvest the iron ore berries, compress them into a iron ingot, and then put them into blast furnace, and therefore have all our steel needs supplied by this ore berry farm. So next episode, the final episode I need for tearing into my harvester, the long wished harvester. Yeah, it will be awesome. So stick around for next episode. I hope you like this episode as well, and have a nice day. See you all around.